वेलकम बैक इन जियोलॉजिकल नॉलेज। सो इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द अनकन्फर्मिटी एंड द टाइप्स ऑफ अनकन्फर्मिटी, वेयर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन और द मेजर डेफिनेशन एंड सम प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ अनकन्फर्मिटी एंड सम डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ अनकन्फर्मिटी लाइक एंगुलर अनकन्फर्मिटी, नॉन अनकन्फर्मिटी और द ब्लेंडेड टाइप ऑफ अनकन्फर्मिटी एंड बटरेस टाइप ऑफ अनकन्फर्मिटी एंड डिसकन्फर्मिटी। सो ऑल दिस टाइप्स ऑफ अनकन्फर्मिटीज एंड देयर इम्पॉर्टेंस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस्ड अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक अबाउट द अनकन्फर्मिटी एंड द बेसमेंट कवर रिलेशनशिप। एंड दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन योर सिलेबस ऑफ जी एस आई मेन्स ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चरल जियोलॉजी पार्ट। सो बिफोर वी डिस्कस द अवर टॉपिक और द डिस्कशन, वी मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड द सम बेसिक्स और द सम बेसिक टर्म्स दैट व्हाट इज द अनकन्फर्मिटी एंड द बेसमेंट कवर रिलेशनशिप। ओके, सो द बेसमेंट, सो एज इन द डायग्राम यू कैन सी दैट इज विद द ग्रीन कलर आई हैव सोन द बेसमेंट एंड विद द इटैलिक रेड डॉट दैट रेड लाइन वी हैव सोन द जिग जैग लाइन दैट हैज बीन इंडिकेटिंग द अनकन्फर्मिटी एज वेल एज द ब्लैक डॉट लाइन्स, ब्लैक लाइन्स रिटन विद सी, दोज रेफर्स टू द कवर। ओके, सो द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द ओल्डर रॉक्स मीन्स द बेसमेंट एंड द यंगर रॉक्स मीन्स द कवर एंड द अनकन्फर्मिटी दैट लाइज इन बिटवीन दीज टू टाइप्स ऑफ रॉक्स और इन दीज टू साइड टू टाइप्स ऑफ बेड्स। सो दैट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट डिसाइफरेंस एंड देयर इज अ ग्रेट सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ दिस अनकन्फर्मिटी एंड बेसमेंट कवर रिलेशनशिप। ओके, सो बेसमेंट दैट लाइज बीनीथ एन अनकन्फर्मिटी ऑफ द रीजनल एक्सटेंट, द फॉर्मेशन अबव द अनकन्फर्मिटी दैट इज रेफर्ड टू एज कवर। ओके, कवर आर मेंटल। तो इन द प्रीवियस आर प्रीवियसली इन द लिटरेचर, सो दिस कवर वॉज नोन एज द मेंटल, बट नाउ द टर्म मेंटल इज डेजिग्नेटेड टू द इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर, द इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द अर्थ वेयर वी कॉल देम द मेंटल और द डीपर पार्ट ऑफ द इंटीरियर ऑफ द अर्थ। सो नाउ द कवर इज मोर रेफरेबल एंड मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्मिनोलॉजी, दैट इज कवर। ओके, सो दिस बेसमेंट कवर रिलेशनशिप विद द अनकन्फर्मिटी, सो दैट इज वेरी सिग्निफिकेंट। ओके, एंड दैट इज द टॉपिक ऑफ टूडेज डिस्कशन। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट अवर टूडेज डिस्कशन। एंड द बेसमेंट कवर रिलेशनशिप एज यू कैन सी इन द डायग्राम इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द स्टैटिग्राफी, स्ट्रक्चरल जियोलॉजी एंड ऑल्सो फॉर एन ओवरऑल अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द प्रोसेस ऑफ द क्रस्टल इवोल्यूशन। सो द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ दिस टॉपिक इज द फॉर द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ द क्रस्ट। ओके, और जनरली नोन एज क्रस्टल इवोल्यूशन। सो इन द डायग्राम एज यू कैन सी देयर आर फोर और फाइव डायग्राम्स। ओके, एज यू कैन सी आई एम जूमिंग इट दैट एज यू कैन सी हियर ए बी सी डी एंड ई, देयर आर फाइव डायग्राम्स। ओके, एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट अवर डिस्कशन। सॉरी दैट गिवन हियर, दैट इज इन फिगर यू कैन सी दिस इज द आइडियलाइज्ड डायग्राम दैट शोज द डाइवर्स टाइप्स ऑफ बेसमेंट कवर रिलेशनशिप। ओके, सो द इंडेक्स एंड देयर क्लस एक्सप्लेनेशन इज गिवन हियर एज इन द डायग्राम ए यू कैन सी द फॉल्टेड बेसमेंट विद द बेसमेंट विज, एज यू कैन सी द बेसमेंट, सॉरी द अनकन्फर्मिटी इज देयर विद द ब्लैक लाइन एंड द इटैलिक लाइन्स दे शो द बेसमेंट एंड द डॉटेड पॉइंट्स दे शो द कवर। सो फॉल्टेड बेसमेंट as you can see in the A diagram, that is the basement is faulted, the faults are being shown, 3 or 4 5 faults are shown here with the basement wedge. And the second one is the B diagram, that is the slice of basement thrust over cover rocks and forming a basement nappe, as you can see. And in the C, the partially remobilized basement doming up the cover rocks, as you can see in the C diagram. the remobilization of the material has taken place, and the basement, the remobilized basement, that is doming up, and that is forming a dome like structure in the old younger rocks to form the cover rocks. Okay, and in the fourth one, that is the D, remobilized core of basement interfolded with cover rocks. As you can see, the basement rocks, they are also covered, as well as the younger rocks or the cover rocks, they are interfolded with the cover rocks. And E diagram, or the fifth one, is the remobilized basement, as you can see in the diagram. Okay, so this was our diagram, and let's go into the our discussion. That is, in the basement cover contact is now a migmatite front. The original contact is not recognizable. Sometimes the contact is recognizable, but sometimes it's not identifiable. Okay, the gneissic complex lying below may contain the unreconstituted basement in certain places. Okay, so the purpose we have discussed, the purpose of this section is to outline the main processes which modify the initial angular unconformity between a basement and its sedimentary cover. Generally, the basement is metamorphic or the igneous formation, and cover is generally the sedimentary origin. Okay, so, and to enumerate the problems of identifying the basement in deformed as well as the metamorphosed terrain. Okay, so that is our motto of the discussion, the purpose of this section. So when a crystalline basement covered with a sediments and with a non-conformity or angular unconformity between the two groups of rocks is deformed in a later orogenic cycle, there may be a different degree of folding of the cover while the basement remains more or less passive. So what is given here, that when a crystalline basement, suppose a crystalline basement means basement is crystalline, means that is formed of igneous or metamorphic rocks. So that is covered with the sediments, means the cover that is sedimentary in origin, with a non-conformity in between this base and the cover, in between the non-conformity is there, or an angular unconformity is there between the two groups of rocks, is deformed in a later orogenic cycle. So the different degree of folding of the core, so the core rocks, they may be folded up to a greater extent while the basement remains more or less passive. Okay, so the degree of deformation or the degree of folding, that may distinguish, that may differentiate. Okay, and the very basic example is in the Jura Mountains. For example, the cover rocks of Mesozoic age, they are detached from the basement of crystalline Paleozoic rocks and are folded independently. Okay, and this process of detachment, that is known as decolement, usually takes place along extremely incompetent beds of anhydrite or the salt bearing clays. Okay, so the process of detachment of the older rocks from the younger rocks, that is known as decolement, or the decolvent process, that usually takes place along the extreme incompetent rocks beds of anhydrite, as you can see here. Okay, so the E diagram, you can see the decolvent of cover rocks over the basement as illustrated by Zura. Okay, so the nature of the original interface can also be identified when the basement is weakly deformed to produce large warps on the interface, or when it is broken up by a number of faults, as you can see in the diagram. As in the first diagram, you have seen that faulted basement, the basement is faulted with basement wedges in the first diagram, as you have seen. Okay, so the basement is weakly deformed to produce a large warps or the interface, or when it is broken up by number of faults, as he has given here, while the cover passively adjusts itself by the folding, as you can see in the diagram. Okay, the interface, however, becomes greatly modified in a type of deformation in which the slices of the basement are thrust into the cover as basement ridges, or as in the extreme case of the Europe Alps. Okay, a slice of the basement is dragged over a low angle thrust fault over rocks which form the sedimentary cover of the Western Alps. So this is a very different example, that is the interface that become greatly modified in the type of deformation in which the slices of the basement, they are thrust into the cover as basement ridges, or as you can see in the diagram, that is in the diagram you can see the slices of basement thrust, they are cover, that cover rocks and forming a basement nape here. Okay, so the basement thrust cover over rocks, over cover rocks, and the formation of basement nape, as you can see in the here basement, the lower basement as written here, that is the basement, but is the basement that is on upper side that given here with an arrow, that shows the basement nape that has formed. Okay, so that is the example in Eastern Alps where the slice of basement is dragged over a low angle thrust fault, or better known as nape, which form a sedimentary cover of the Western Alps. So these are very two basic examples of relationship, as well as the occurrence of conglomerate bed that has also been identified along the cyst-gneiss contact, no doubt strongly suggests that the interface represents an unconformity surface. Okay, so generally the occurrence of conglomerate that shows the occurrence so what happens, that is in the presence of conglomerate at an unconformity, a bed of conglomerate is commonly found at the base of the upper series of the rocks. So such conglomerates contain fragments of the underlying rocks. Okay, so these conglomerates, so that presence shows that these are formed or the contain the fragments of the underlying rocks. Okay, however, a conglomerate may not be present in all such terrains. So this is obvious, that is if the basic rocks or the basal rocks, they contain fragments of underlying rocks, then there will be the presence of conglomerate. But the presence of conglomerate is not essential in all types of rocks. Okay, but there is some precautions while identifying the surface of erosion from the presence of the conglomerate bed. In such strongly deformed terrain, one should be careful to distinguish between a true sedimentary conglomerate and a autoclastic conglomerate. Okay, so this is very important to distinguish between the true sedimentary conglomerate as well as the autoclastic conglomerate. Okay, an autoclastic conglomerate is generally produced by intense deformation and fragmentation of a layer, and that may look like very similar to the true conglomerate. So the differentiation is very important. Okay, autoclastic conglomerate and the true sedimentary conglomerate both looks like the same. So the differentiation and the identification is very important. While establishing the presence of an angular unconformity in such strongly deformed terrains, one should always remember that the angular relationship must be between the two depositional surfaces of the two groups of rocks. Suppose there are two types of rocks. Okay, the unconformity and basement cover relationship means the basement as well as the younger rocks or the upper rocks or the cover, better known as. So these two types of rocks, they may be of different ages as well as different orientation and the different composition. Okay, so one must take a careful attention in the strongly deformed terrains, that is the angular relationship must be between the depositional surfaces of the two groups of rocks. Okay, the rocks they must be of two different orientation and two different composition. Okay, otherwise there it will be very difficult for you to understand or to distinguish the basement cover relationship, because the rocks of the basement and the cover, these are of same origin. So it will be very hectic and very difficult for you to understand that relationship, basement cover relationship. Okay, so for this, thus an angular unconformity is not established when the bedding or foliation of the cyst belt or the banding and the foliation of the gneisses terminate against the cyst gneiss boundary. Okay, that is why the bedding or the foliation of the cyst belt or the banding and the foliation of the gneiss terminate against the cyst gneiss boundary, because this boundary doesn't necessarily represents a depositional surface. That's why the cyst gneiss boundary, that doesn't represents the depositional surface. In all such cases, one should always make a careful analysis of the structural histories of the cyst belt and the gneissic complex. If one knows the structural history of these cyst belt and the gneissic complexes, so that will be very easy for one to understand the basement cover relationship. Means that what type of rocks are there and what is the degree of deformation or the degree of metamorphism in particular types of rocks. Okay, so the gneissic, so the cyst belt and the gneissic complex deformational history, that is very important in identifying the basement cover relationship. An unconformity is likely to be present if the earliest structure of synkinematic magmatitic complex can also be traced to the bordering cyst belt. Okay, so the structure of a synkinetic magmatitic complex can also be traced to the bordering of the cyst belt. Okay, the detailed study of the Precambrian terrain has revealed a geological history of great complexity. That's an Indian example. The nature of the complex relationship between the basement and the cover in such terrains can be understood from the following example of Precambrian of central and southern Rajasthan in the western part of Indian Seal. Okay, so the example is here the Precambrian rocks of central and southern Rajasthan in the western part of Indian Seal. Here we have a vast terrain of metamorphosed sedimentary rocks, metamorphosed sediments and lava flows of the Aravalli group. Okay, so these are the type area. The Aravalli cycle of orogeny that closed around 2000 to 1900 million years ago. Okay, so that is important, that Aravalli cycle of orogeny that has closed at an around 2000 to 1900 million years ago. The Aravalli groups of rocks is bordered by the terrains of migmatites, okay, forming the banded gneissic complex, the famous banded gneissic complex. They are the migmatite origin, migmatite forming the BGC, and BGC doesn't have a separate structural entity, and this is very important for you to understand that banded gneissic complex, it doesn't have any separate structural entity, and all the generation of folds and the foliation in it, they are also occurring in the Aravalli groups of rocks, because the Aravalli groups of rocks, they are continuously being folded and faulted in the structural history. Okay, the folds of each generation, they have the same style in both the metasediment as well as the gneisses. Okay, and moreover, it has been also demonstrated that the migmatization in the banded gneiss complex, they are broadly synkinematic, with the first deformation affecting the rocks of the Aravalli group. Okay, these relationship, they are apparently indicating the Aravalli metasediments cannot be younger than the BGC. Okay, so this is the significance of the basement cover relationship, the relationship, apparent relationship that indicates that the Aravalli metasediments, they cannot be younger than banded gneissic complex. Okay, means they will be older than, sorry, they may be older than BGC, that implies. ऑन द अदर हैंड द बीजीसी इन द सदर्न राजस्थान कंटेन्स रॉक्स एज ओल्डर एज 3500 मिलियन ईयर्स ओके और 3.5 बिलियन ईयर्स अगो सो दे आर वेरी ओल्डर रॉक्स एंड मोर ओवर इन सर्टन प्लेसेस अ कॉन्ग्लोमरेट कंटेनिंग नाइसिक पेबल्स दैट अकर्स एट द कॉन्टैक्ट बिटवीन द अरावलीज एंड द बैंडन नाइसिक कॉम्प्लेक्स सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दैट द प्रेजेंस ऑफ कॉन्ग्लोमरेट दैट इज अ क्लियर कट एग्जाम्पल दैट इज अ क्लियर कट इंडिकेशन ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एन अनकन्फर्मिटी सो द conglomerate that contains gneissic pebbles that occurs at the contact between the aravallis and the BGC. So aravalli being the cover and the BGC that is the basement. So that is the basement cover relationship and conformity in between that is formed by the conglomerates of the gneissic and pebble origin. So these relationship are in agreement with the conclusion that the BGC represents an ancient basement on which the Aravalli sediments were unconformably deposited. So that is the conclusion. Okay, that banded gneissic complex, the older one or the base or the basement that is representing an ancient basement on which the younger or the Aravalli sediments they were unconformably deposited. So the complexity of the basement cover relationship arises from these two sets of apparently contradictory findings. Okay. So this was our discussion, and if we talk about the unconformity basement relationship, there is another example in the southwestern part of India, that is in the Kalatgir Basin. Okay. Kalatgir Basin, where the Archean basement, the basement is of Archean age, and the overlying Mesoproterozoic sediments that is forming the cover, and in between there is an well-known unconformity. So the basement forming a part of the western Dharwan Craton. So the basement that is basement forms a part of western Dharwan Craton is an assemblage of the Archean peninsular gneissic complexes and granites. So granites better known as close-pit granite or CPG granites. Okay, so the basement that form a part of western Dharwar Craton is an assemblage of the Archean peninsular gneissic complex, better known as CPG or close-pit granite. Okay, so I'm not going into the detail of this Kalatgir Basin correlation. I will provide the research paper link in the description box, and from there you can understand and find the basement cover relationship. Okay, and in the description box you can get the PDF file or the link of the PDF file. Okay, thank you.